Hello everyone, and welcome to the July 2025 Sky Report. My name is Vanessa, and I'm joined today by Patrick.
Hi everyone.
Let's see what's happening in the skies this month.
On the morning of July 12, just before dawn, Venus and the star Epsilon Tauri will be separated by less than the diameter of the Moon, just 13 arc minutes apart. This close conjunction is best observed with binoculars. Epsilon Tauri is sometimes associated with the eye of Taurus the Bull, although it's not as prominent as Aldebaran, the brighter and more well-known eye of Taurus. Venus is about 1,000 times brighter than Epsilon Tauri, which adds a temporary eye to the V-shaped pattern of the stars that represents the head of the bull.
On July 20th, the Moon and the bright open cluster, the Pleiades, rise on the eastern horizon. The Moon will travel across the cluster in our sky, covering a few of the bright stars at a time. Pictured here at 2:30 a.m., the bright stars Alcyone and Merope are covered. At 1:50 a.m., as the Moon and the Pleiades are rising, the bright star Electra of the Seven Sisters is covered. As the Moon travels, at 2:30, it then covers Alcyone. At 3 a.m., the Moon approaches Pleione and Atlas. By 3:30, Pleione is covered. And by 4 a.m., Pleione is visible again and the occultation has ended. Early in the morning of July 23rd, there will be a grouping of notable objects on the eastern horizon. The very delicate 2% crescent moon will be very low on the horizon. Look for the moon with a pair of binoculars to see more detail. The moon will continue to rise, but you'll want to look for it well before the sun rises. The planets Jupiter and Venus will also be visible, along with some of the brightest stars in the sky, like Betelgeuse, Rigel, Capella, and Aldebaran.
The seven Delta Aquariid meteor shower will peak from the night of July 30th to the early morning of July 31st. This shower is known for its bright meteors and is best viewed from seven latitudes. In Southern California, only a limited number of meteors may be visible under clear dark skies far from city lights. To the east, the bright stars Vega in Lyra the Harp, Deneb in Cygnus the Swan, and Altair in Aquila the Eagle form the asterism known as the Summer Triangle. Looking west, the Big Dipper sinks low towards the northwest horizon. If you trace a line back along the handle of the Dipper, it leads you to Arcturus, a bright orange star in the constellation Boötes the Herdsman. From there, you can speed downwards to Spica, the brightest star in the constellation Virgo the Maiden.
To the south, we see a couple of summer constellations prominently in the sky. Scorpius and Sagittarius sit low in the south. We cannot see it here in Los Angeles due to light pollution, but the Milky Way travels through the constellation we saw in the east, Cygnus the Swan, and through Sagittarius, seen here. Looking towards Sagittarius, we are looking into the heart of our galaxy. Light pollution does keep us from seeing it clearly. If you want to learn more about light pollution and its effects, visit darksky.org. Let's take a look at what the planets are up to this month. Venus stays in the early morning sky and will be visible before the sun rises all month. As the month progresses, Venus will continue its journey closer to the sun from our perspective. It's seen here moving through the constellation of Taurus as it approaches the horizon. By the 31st, Venus will sit just above the horizon before sunrise. Below it, we can also see the planet Jupiter just barely rising before the sun at the end of the month.
Mars continues its rapid movement. On the 1st, it's located under the constellation Leo the Lion to the west. By the middle of the month, Mars moves about 17 moon diameters to the east. At the end of the month, Mars is in the constellation Virgo. Mars will have moved 36 moon diameters to the east. On the 1st, it sets at 11:22 p.m., and by the 31st, it sets at 10:09 p.m. The elusive planet Mercury reaches its greatest angular separation west of the Sun on the evening of July 3rd. This is the best time to see the planet, as it will be at a maximum separation of 26 degrees away from the Sun. As the closest planet to the Sun, it remains close to the horizon in the twilight, making it a challenge to observe. To catch a glimpse, look towards the west 45 minutes after sunset, when the twilight is still fading. A pair of binoculars will make it easier to spot.
By the end of the month pictured here, the planet Saturn will rise before midnight. If you stay up late or wake up early, it climbs high in the sky all month, so it is a great time to watch the planet. In case you needed more of a reason to watch Saturn, we are in the middle of a special viewing season for the planet. There is a short time period in Saturn's orbit where we are able to watch its largest moon, Titan, cast a shadow on the disk of the planet. This only happens for a short period of time before and after Saturn's ring crossing. Two of these rare events will happen this month, on July 2nd and late on the 17th into the early morning of the 18th. Both of these shadow transits will last for a little over 5 hours. You will need a stronger telescope to get a good view. Some say that it is visible with a 3-inch telescope, but if you're still training your eye into an astronomer's eye, a bigger telescope will help. On July 2nd, the shadow transit begins at 12:23 a.m. and ends at about 6 a.m. This shadow transit begins when Saturn is a little bit higher in the sky, but it ends after the sun has risen. This means the middle of the transit will be great for viewing, but the beginning and end may be washed out by poor seeing or bright light, respectively. On July 17th, the shadow transit begins at 11:43 p.m. and ends at about 5:03 a.m. on July 18th. This transit starts off with the planet lower on the horizon, but ends before the sun rises. This is your chance to see the end of the shadow transit that may have been washed out by daylight on the 2nd. There will be more opportunities to see a transit until October, but don't wait because the last one in October only grazes the edge of the planet. The transits will get shorter and shorter until we exit the season, and it will not happen again for another 14 years. And here is your lunar calendar for the month. First quarter is on the 2nd. Full moon is on the 10th. Last quarter is on the 17th. And the new moon is on the 24th. Thank you so much for joining us this month, and we'll see you again next month. Bye!
Bye.